Our cities will need smart technology to meet the energy needs of the future. Between now and 2035, urban population growth and increased use of electric transport will lead to rising energy demand in the UK's big cities. This brings challenges, but also opportunities. In Bristol, for example, domestic electrical consumption is expected to increase by over a third in the next 20 years. But local organisations and Bristol City Council are already transforming their approach and using energy in a more sustainable way.
So we set up the Bristol Smart Energy City Collaboration because we could see an enormous opportunity for a city like Bristol to take initiative. We brought all these different perspectives together and really thought through what opportunities existed out of smart energy data and making better use of it at city level. And what we've done is created a set of roadmaps, one to focus on curbing energy waste and cutting demand, one focusing on how you might enhance the value of local renewable energy generation, and then thirdly, and very importantly, how you'd use the smart energy data to target better interventions and better support to people in fuel poverty. The success of the Bristol Smart Energy City Collaboration really rests on people continuing to work together, but also that we start to see at a national level policies, programs, commercial and regulatory frameworks change to accommodate and enable city initiative in relation to smart energy, something that is a crucial component of Bristol being able to succeed in becoming a smart energy city.
We're involved in the Smart Energy Collaboration because we really believe that collaboration works. And although we can do lots of interesting things on our own in terms of generating our own electricity or using energy-saving devices, we know that the real gains are made when we work with other people. Bristol City Council has cross-party support and signed up to Bristol Carbon Neutral by 2050. The Smart Energy Collaboration is trying to do the same thing. It's saying, how can we use the introduction of smart meters, both the disruption in people's lives of the rollout and the opportunity of the new data, to address fuel poverty, support greater renewables, and reduce energy demand overall.
And Bristol isn't alone in its efforts. Nottingham will see domestic electricity demand rise by over 25% by 2035. But it's already made great progress in creating a smarter, more sustainable city.
Nottingham Energy Partnership is a charity that is very proud to have won the Queen's Award for Sustainable Development. And its focus is very much on tackling climate change and also fuel poverty. A good example would be in an area that's really deprived, where we delivered solid wall insulation for over 1,000 properties. We'll go into a community and both the private sector and the social housing sector will be able to benefit from the grants that we're able to offer. Recent projects has been focusing on innovation. As a result, we have a 5 megawatt solar farm in Nottinghamshire. 1,150 homes will be able to benefit from that. I think smart technology really is the final piece of the jigsaw. It means that energy is finally visible for householders, for consumers, and certainly for our clients, our customers. They will see the benefit straight away.
The transition to a more sophisticated energy network will help cities to manage economic growth and development in the decades ahead. Smart meters are the catalyst for the transition to smart cities. They are being offered to every home and micro business in Great Britain. The new technology will offer consumers greater control over their energy use and will also help our cities become smarter, enabling a smart grid and the mass take-up of low-carbon technologies. Cities are already starting to seize some of the opportunities of smart technology, helping to build a greener, more efficient Britain.